I started skiing when I was 7 years old, and my parents took me to Elk Mountain, and I was miserable and I cried a lot, but it took me a few years. But by the time I was like 9 or 10, I was like skiing all the black diamonds. I love skiing, and I've skied forever.
So skiing and snowboarding, just being in the outdoors, is a pretty spectacular opportunity for anyone to kind of partake in and participate. The unique thing about skiing and snowboarding is that it's seasonal, and it takes you into an environment that is unique to most of the world. Whether it's in the high mountains of the Sierras where I've been skiing, or even just here in Pennsylvania, in the densely wooded hills.
You know, I grew up skiing. I grew up in New Jersey, actually, and my whole family was into skiing. And in fact, I grew up in this really fun little neighborhood in New Jersey, in like a suburb of New York City, that had a lot of skiers in it. And one of the families had a house in Vermont. And so multiple weekends of winter, we would all pile into a small station wagon, and we would drive up to Vermont, and we'd spend the weekends then sledding and skiing at a small mountain in Vermont called Pico.
In the past 14 years that I've been skiing, more and more often, ski seasons have been a lot shorter. Like, note, I worked at Elk Mountain, which is near my home, and sometimes they would close in like March as opposed to like April or even like February. Like, there was one year where there were season passes, and the season passes like 100 days at Elk Mountain, and they got to day 70, and they had to give like tons of people refunds, and that's becoming really, really common. And Montage Mountain near Scranton sometimes just hasn't even opened for an entire season, and I just see that becoming more and more common.
I guess climate change is a touchy subject for the ski industry, and quite frankly, climate change does not simply mean a lack of snow or warmer weather. It's, as I've seen in California, as I'm seeing this season specifically here, that it just means that there's more radical changes so far in the winter season. So the last three seasons in California, we've had wonderful seasons. And now California is having a dry season as well. So I come out here and I realize that even though California is this large, skiing-oriented area in the Eastern Sierras, even in Pennsylvania, with it being a dry season, actually warmer than it should be for winter, that it fluctuates. And I have seen and heard from others that this is one of the worst seasons, one of the worst winters that State College in Pennsylvania has seen.
Issues related to climate change are really affecting a lot of different recreational activities right now. And skiing in the Northeast, and especially in the southern tier of the Northeast at low elevation, will absolutely be affected. And that's something that's really hard to watch. You know, it's like we all grow up skiing in these places, and we all grew up loving skiing and loving that accessibility. And climate change is absolutely going to affect some of these places. They have adapted. You know, if you look at smaller ski areas, they're developing better technology as it relates to snowmaking. And that technology is getting better and more accessible. And so small areas, even like Tussey, are making more snow and really delivering on decent conditions, despite the fact that there hasn't been really wintry weather this season. I think they've done a really great job in stitching together enough skiing to keep people moving. And so that takes a lot of energy on their part and a lot of work. What the probability says is that over time, it's going to get warmer, which means that the season will be shorter and storms will be more intense and varied. And that can be intense, it can be really cold, and that can be intense where it can be really warm at different times. And the problem with that is it makes it all very unpredictable. And I think smaller mountains have a hard time operating in unpredictable conditions.
I've been pleasantly surprised by the community I've come into, coming from California and being in Pennsylvania, and specifically being at Tussey. I started to understand how important these smaller resorts are, these smaller ski centers are for the industry, because so many people in towns nearby, the school districts, State College itself, can come to Tussey and learn how to ski without the intimidation of being at a big mountain.
I hope skiing doesn't like go entirely by the wayside, because it's a sport that's been around for a really long time. But skiing in the northeast part of the country, I think, is really at risk of becoming something that's only seen as like for the super rich or tiny indoor ski hills. And I think that would be a shame.
You know, one of the things that I love about Tussey and the Tussey community is that people at Tussey love to ski. And obviously that seems like, yeah, of course they're there. But what I mean by that is you spend more time going up than you do going down. And when people love skiing that much, where they're doing laps all day and perfecting their turns and you know, laughing together and seeing each other from the lift, it just becomes this incredible community. I love that little mountain.